Hotep Shalom Namaste. KTS Cole Asher Hava. Bringing you another video broadcasting live on behalf of the Elohim and righteous spirits and the Dharmapala. Today we're going to talk about the chakras, this energy that is within all of us. What the Hindus have talked about, that is within us. They have written these things down, and there's scientific studies about this that proves that this power that lies within us is real. This energy that we can manifest to heal one another, to help one another, to bring each other happiness and to bring ourselves happiness, not to rely on technology no more. This energy really exists. You must be in this. The secret is you must be in harmony with your heart, mind, and soul, and body. You must be in harmony with who you are. You must know who you are. You must love yourself. You should not need nothing from nobody. You should not need nothing from no outside source. Don't depend on no money, no technology, no nothing. Okay, but we're going to go ahead and get into this chakra. I'm going to teach you all about the manifestations of the chakra, how you can manifest anything. Yeah, you ever been in a relationship and it was like, the relationship was nothing, it was just BS, you know, the relationship, it just really didn't work at all. Your energy centers wasn't aligned. Your aura, what you yourself, who you were not pure. Now, even though you didn't know this, it's still your fault, because you should know everything about you. You should know who you are. You should want to study these things. That's just as you study the human anatomy. These chakras are within your spirit. Like you have a heart in your body, a brain within your body, lungs and intestines and livers and kidneys. You have that in the physical body. But the chakras, they all consist of the spiritual body. These are the things that lies within your etherical body, your astral body, your spirit body. But let's go ahead and get into this. The first chakra we have at the base of the spine is the Muladhara, or the root chakra. This deals with survival and is blocked by fear. When this chakra is meditated on, all fear is destroyed. When it's meditated on sincerely and concentrated on, it destroys all fear. The second chakra we have, Swadhisthana, which means sweet to the taste. Swadhisthana, or the sacral chakra, which is two fingers below the belly button. The Swadhisthana deals with emotions and intimacy, and is blocked by guilt, which means if you are guilty of anything, you should basically let it go, because you cannot harness the energy of the sacral chakra, which we will get into a little bit deeper. You cannot harness the energy of the sacral chakra or use this energy if you have strong amounts of negative emotions such as guilt. Now, there's something else I also want to say about the sacral chakra. The sacral chakra is also in what the Chinese call the Dan Tien, where the energy is stored. Dan Tien means elixir field. When you want to build up chi energy, right? This is where you pull it, into the sacral chakra. Two fingers below the belly button. If you ever feel like doing anything, don't do it. Whether it be, anything, you can think of anything. Be still and know that I am God. If you feel like doing anything, don't do it. Instead, bring all that anxiety, all that energy into the Dan Tien, the sacral chakra. And this will create your chi, take it to the heart chakra and create jing, and to the crown and create shen. But that will be in another video. Right now we're going to focus on the chakras. Okay. The next chakra we have here is Manipura. The Manipura, the solar plexus chakra, is three fingers above the belly button. The solar plexus deals with willpower and is blocked by shame. The solar plexus is a very interesting chakra for many reasons, because the solar plexus, it also deals with like the will to do and to act. Many people, when you see that they can't really make up their mind about things, they have a weak willpower. When you see people like just enslavement and they just doing any and everything, they have a weak willpower. You always need a strong willpower. It's very important to have a strong willpower. Without willpower, you can be easily controlled. Easily controlled. You have to have a strong willpower. But the esoteric meaning behind all these is a lot deeper, but we'll touch on that in another subject. The next chakra is the Anahata, which is the heart chakra, and is located at the heart. The heart chakra deals with love and is blocked by grief. So like when you're mourning and you're grieving, obviously the heart chakra is not at its full potential because you're in mourning. However, you must always heal from these. There's nothing wrong with mourning and grieving, but you must always get over it. You must always get through it. You must understand the cause of suffering, the nature of suffering, the reason why you're suffering. You must understand all these things. And this is what will cure you of suffering. But at the same time, even the heart chakra is, that's what I meant to tell you. The heart chakra is at the middle. It's in the middle. You have three at the top and you have three at the bottom. The heart chakra is the middle. And the heart chakra is governed by love. Its main focus is love. Love is the key to the kingdom of heaven. Love is the key. The key opened up many doors. That's what keys do. But this is not just any kind of key. This is your key. Basically, you are creating your heaven based on what you love, what you hate. Based off what you cry for, based off what you are inspired by. All your emotions is creating your heaven right now. Your hell. All of this is creating your afterlife. All of this. All of what you're doing right now, just you reading this or listening to this, is creating your heaven. Love is the key, literally, to the kingdom. Which is why Christ tells us, love thine enemies. But that's a whole nother subject and a whole nother video by itself. The next chakra we have is Vishuddha, basically, which means purity. And Vishuddha is located at the throat, which is also called the throat chakra. The throat chakra deals with purity, speech, self-expression, and creativity, and is blocked by lies. So, like, in order for us to come in harmony with mind, body, and soul, all seven chakras must be meditated on, must be concentrated on. You must purify yourself, inward and outward. Meditate on these seven chakras and purify your mind, body, soul, and spirit. Your manifestations will be pure. If you want love, you will get love because you are in tune with who you are. You are in tune with who you are. And this all comes from the throat chakra, which deals with truth. Now, the esoteric meaning behind this, whatever you say is the truth. Whatever you say, your word is law. If you tell yourself you are a bum, you're weak, you're stupid, you're not worth it, anything, you won't. Your relationships will be like that. You won't be worth nothing. Your relationships will be bull. It will be BS. It will be on false premise and false intentions and false love and false promises. That is why you must always be true to yourself. You must always tell yourself who you are and what do you want in out of this life. And if you tell yourself you don't deserve a good man, you will get a bad man. If you tell yourself you don't deserve a good life, you gonna get that bad life, because your word is truth. Whatever you speak into the universe, it will pick up on it like a computer and feed it back to you. Period. You must train your subconscious mind and be stronger than what you are mentally, spiritually, and emotionally. You cannot keep going on into this world living the way you live, because if you keep doing that, you will end up hurting yourself to the point where you may not be able to reverse it, because you've already dig a pit so deep you cannot come out of it. You always got to be true to who you are. In the Bible, it tells us that, I believe it's First James, but James tells us that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. You are God, and your word is truth. Whatever you say will come to light. Whatever you say will happen, whether you believe it or not. If you speak ill will on somebody and they are innocent of your curse, that energy, that negative energy will come back to you and probably kill you. Period. It doesn't take a rocket scientist to know that common courtesy is applied to all people. Every action has an opposite and equal reaction. You must know these things, because in the end, everybody will benefit from the truth. I mean, those who do righteous will benefit from it. Those who do wicked will be destroyed. So always speak truth. Never speak ill will on nobody. Stay true to who you are. Be a positive person. Be pure. You got to be in harmony with who you are in order to have perfect and good manifestations. The next chakra we have is the Ajna, the third eye chakra, or the brow chakra. The third eye chakra sees through illusions, and it deals with intuition and psychic abilities. When people claim they see ghosts, etc., it's because their third eye is very powerful. Many children have a strong third eye. This is why many children, like, you can ask, if you have a child under the age of 6, ask them about anything from a past life, or ask them anything that is otherworldly. They will give you an answer, out of this world answer. Like, when I'm gonna ask my daughter, the first question I will ask my daughter is, where did you come from? Who sent you? Everybody should be on this spiritual path. You should all ask your children, where did you come from? How did you get here? Their third eye is open. They will see these things. They will see these things. At an early age, they know this. You can watch ghost documentaries. It's always the children and the animals who know these, who can see these spirits. Because the third eye is opened. The third eye is very, very sensitive with the child. The third eye is powerful, brothers and sisters. You must understand that in this reality, in order to succeed, first of all, you must ask yourself, what is success? Second of all, you must define who you are and stay in harmony with who you are. But the third eye is powerful among children, and it is blocked by illusions. You cannot live your life based off illusions. You can't, brothers and sisters. You cannot live your life based off of lies and illusions. You cannot live your life based off of what you've been told. You must seek the truth, because this world, you all have been deceived. But I'm going to free you. Amen. You have all been deceived. You have all been deceived. But you can always come to truth. It is never too late. You must come to the truth, and you must come to the realization that what you have within you can save this world. You're not an ordinary human made of flesh and bones and blood. You are better than that. It doesn't matter what these scientists tell you. None of that really matters. None of that matters. You are more than that. You are more than flesh and bones. You have a powerful spirit within you that radiates brighter than a million suns, which is not lit and which is not shined stars and fire and electricity. Your soul is lit, and it radiates with the power and the brilliance of your actions. The more good you do, the brighter your soul will shine. The more knowledge you know, the brighter your soul will shine. You are creating your afterlife right now. This life is only a test. You have been deceived. This life is only a test. Nothing more but a test to see who's worthy and to see who's not. Now, the last and final chakra is the Sahasrara. Sahasrara. Okay, and the crown, or in English, would be the crown chakra. And the crown chakra is the chakra of enlightenment, the chakra of understanding and knowledge and wisdom. The final chakra is also blocked by attachment. You cannot be attached to this world. You must give away all things of this world. Everything of this world, you must give it away. It doesn't, if your hands didn't create it, give it away. It's not yours, you don't need it. Point blank, period. You need nothing of this world. If your hands didn't create it, you don't need it. If it's not from within you, you don't need it. Everything you have, everything you need will come from you, will come from the in your soul, your spirit, love, happiness, joy. It will all come from within you. You don't need nothing. Every day you should pray and meditate and manifest this this beautiful reality that is around us. You can make the world a better place with your love. I call you God, I call you Goddess, because your love is needed to heal this world. Your energy, your spiritual prowess is needed. All this technology can be destroyed. We don't need these things. They tell you to get a job and pay taxes. You have been trapped into the matrix. You've been trapped. We all must help one another and free one another. When you see a homeless person, you give them shelter. When you see a hungry person, you give them food. When you see a man who doesn't know, who's ignorant, you put him on the right path and give him wisdom. Put him on and lead the way. Help them fight the demons, and don't walk the path for nobody. Don't do it for nobody. Do it with them. Don't do nothing for nobody. Everybody is responsible for their own salvation. Again, you can manifest anything in this world. All you have to do is be in harmony with who you are. How do you be in harmony? Align these seven energy centers so you can be perfectly and pure, and have a pure spirit, a pure mind, and a pure body. You must have a pure spirit, body, and mind in order to be in harmony. And when you are in harmony, only then will your manifestations be perfect. But your manifestations are crooked and messed up and evil and wicked. And they are impure because you are impure. But in the next video, I'm going to get deeper into the esoteric sciences and the knowledge on how do you use your chakras as weapons and how to manifest. Actually, how to manifest. Good, the yin and the yang on how to manifest your spiritual energy, your chi. We'll get deeper into the next video, everybody. But thanks for watching. Cole Asher Hava. KT Addis, stay blessed, everybody.